came from. Part of me wants to stay and study this place, but part of me is, can I survive in this heat? Yes, but I'm not thrilled about it.
entering United Colony space. Maintain course and prepare to be scanned. All right, we're done. You're clear to land and you're landed.
Never minded the solitude before, but chasing more ghosts than usual. Every noise seems to set the blood running. The spanner's torque is what the eye needs now. We'll fix her good as new. Lucky I noticed the pattern in one of those artifacts you pulled out. Here. Never minded the solitude before. But chasing more ghosts than usual. Every noise seems to set the blood running. That's why I missed your little welcome party. Got caught up plotting all the data the eye can give us. Wouldn't mind the helper's hand, though. Could speed the process along. Up-to-date planetary scans would help filter all the data I have to sift through. Maybe help to find the anomalous bits. And Constellation can slide a credit or two your way. All part of the mission of charting the stars, right? When you're orbiting a planet, your ship's scanners can pick up all sorts of information. Signs of life, resources, structures where they shouldn't be. It all gets downloaded into data you can hand over to anyone who's interested. And Constellation is always more interested than most. Been washing red here and there all over.
at this place. So many questions come to mind, I don't even know where to start. Exploration is all about. many times we see these, I'm always going to be impressed. Constellation dreams
Hello,
of this
universe.
Moment.
This is Barrett, returning your call.
What in the... Who in the... Whoa. Hello, handsome. You've got to be joking. Nope. Okay. Skipping the initial shock of it all. Agreed. Not worth it. Forming a hypothesis. That doesn't make sense. Cloning is a complicated procedure involving a lot of complex science. This was... a whole lot weirder. That's one way to put it. Molecular binary schism? Temporal twinning? Group hallucination? Don't forget the fluctuations in the energy patterns, which align almost deterministically. Harmonized vibrations distorting some mechanical barrier between neighboring universes? Impossible to know with such a minute subset of readings. We need more data.
Obviously.
I'll be Barrett Prime. Amundsen is fine. Usually the barrier between us is too thick to communicate much anyway. Amundsen? Now I know you're not me. Hey, one of us has to keep it classy. Why stop at two? It won't work. The energy required increases exponentially per anomaly. I'm already exhausted. In a way that's hard to describe. Not physically or mentally, but something else. Sorry, friend. You'll feel right as rain when I dissipate. Whoa, there. Sustaining this connection requires a lot of concentration. Is this permanent? You will eventually monitor the energy fluctuations and agree. But no, this is unusual. I could study this forever. Urban told me to just enjoy it and collect data on the side for later. And I'm glad I did. Irvin? He's with you. He's... okay? by the tone of your voice. I'm gathering some things in our lives might be a bit different. Is he happy? Yes, he is. Our daughter pilots the ship after Vasco was destroyed. But otherwise, we've survived the war well. I have so many questions. I wonder how many paths I've taken. We've taken. How many variations. How many ended with heartache and how many with joy. I think about that all the time. Wait. What's that noise? Starborn ship. We can handle this. On it. Something happened. Sometimes these places are kind of creepy. Just being serious. Something happened. I can't hold on to you. I'm struggling. Being pulled through the barrier. This is probably it, friends. Amundsen? Cherish every moment with them.
I already do, my friend. I promise.
So look, for the record, I am the same Barrett that came here with you. For sure. I think. Could you imagine if I just kept pulling other Barretts into existence? Forever? An entire universe full of me. True. How would I stand out in a crowd made entirely of myself anyway? Anyway, it's a relief, you know. I have this ability, this power. And I'm still just me. Just regular Barrett. And they already feel like it's subsiding. I no longer feel like I'm in a huge crowd. Yes. Though it takes a lot of concentration. If I do it a lot, I bet I'd give myself a headache. From myself. I'm my own migraine. I thought so too. Other me, other Barrett, seemed like he was able to handle himself well in that fight. Anyway, we'll see. If the other me gets in the way, I can just release him. Or stop using the power entirely. For now, I just need to use this power a bit and digest what all has happened. I lost my Irvin. I know that. I wish beyond anything that he appeared in that temple instead of me. But it helps to know there's an Irvin out there somewhere living a life full of love with someone like me. I can move forward with that thought in my heart. Sure, but give me some time. I want to use it a bit more. See what its limits are. I just need some time with it. It's pretty exhausting, really. So I might only do it when I feel like we could use backup. For now, anyway.
Be advised, you are entering United Colony space. Please maintain course and prepare to be scanned. Scan complete. You are clear to land in New Atlantis. Please enjoy your visit to Jemison.
Never minded the solitude before, but chasing more ghosts than usual. Every noise seems to set the blood running. Been washing red here and there. Oh. The eyes showing signs over another one of those big anomalies. Here, catch a smile. The spanner's torque is what the eye needs now. We'll fix her good as new. Keep coming back to one thing. Both of these Starborn, they're people you know. Only they're not the people you know. Say and do things the folks you know would never. Doesn't bode well for anyone stepping into the Unity. Or through it, or however it works. You consider what it might do to you? Easy to say when you're on this side of it, but give some thought to who or what might come out the other side. No loss as great as the loss of what you are. Ever run the scholars on the Centaurus Proclamation? The original treaty that gave every human the right to colonize the stars? Stolen by some fool's joke of a Crimson Fleet rook looking to trade names to Captain. Sight to see pinned above my chair, like the whole settled systems was mine for the taking. Time dances its years forward, and I'd retired. That's when our own Sarah Morgan walks into the tale. Fire in her eyes and her head full of intel I thought I had spent the labor's efforts burying. Of course, I didn't have the Centaurus Proclamation just lounging in my pockets. Belonged to the ship and her new captain in the fleet I had left behind. Tipped your ear long enough, but the short line of it, Sarah and I returned the treaty to the rightful owners, and I decided to hang around, lend an old pirate's wisdom to the mission. I make the visit when they need me. Don't mind the loner's life most days, and the eye is important work. But I should make the trip more often. Can't let Walter be the only one tending bar there too long. Everyone will forget what a good drink tastes like. The spanner's torque is what the...
much fun as...
Dust is all you will be.
Comments? Questions? No? Good.
Thank you.
like we're making history right here, right now?
Landing site's clear. All the way here.
Good to see you. Is mining on the schedule today? Don't do anything stupid out there.
I hope Cora doesn't get too much underfoot. It's good to be out and about. Lodge gets stuffy sometime. Cora will be thrilled.
Sam! Two better have some good adventures to tell me about later on.
Adventure is my middle name. Well, not really, but now I kind of wish it was.
Hey, now the party can get started.
Glad to see you're back in one. Very good. Let's go.
Something? I don't know about you. You know me. I'm always up for the next adventure.
Okay. Let me know when you need me again.
Thank you. of things. Not bad. Not bad. My life is an open book. Well, mostly open. Well, just ask. There's so many planets, moons, celestial phenomena out there. Most captains just sail through the great black, not even really looking, appreciating. A lot of the time, touching down on a virgin planet can be, well, uneventful. But every now and then, you see something no human has ever laid eyes on. That is what I live for. Man, the galaxy's too big to be stuck in the same place. Depends on the question. Shoot. Korra has the complete top of its class learning videos and lessons. And I have to occasionally do some of the old homeschooling. Fortunately, mainly it's the videos. Around when she was 7, she could already see the cracks in my knowledge. Come to think of it, I think she's doing an introductory college course in astrophysics. Not being graded, like, for fun. She's so weird. I've seen my fair share of scrapes. Actually, a triple share with a massive bonus worth. Some folks say I'm the luckiest man alive after making it through some real whoppers. But the trick is to always keep a cool head. Impulsiveness, fear, adrenaline, all those will get you jumpy. You get too jumpy, your target could be 5 in front of you and you'll miss every time. There's no next. I want to be exploring until they pry the boots off my cold dead feet. I mean, Korra will go to university, and the price tag there is scarier than any jam we've been in. But for me, my truest love is the next star, the next horizon.
Let's see what's on this ball.